Hello, my name is Rachel, and I love clothes. And I am continuing my birthday month hauls. I have yet another Killstar haul. So Killstar first had that $10, $20, $30 sale, which I did that haul last week. And then right afterwards, they did a 30% off sale. So then I grabbed some things from their clearance section because it was even 30% off their clearance. So I grabbed some stuff from the clearance section. And then after that, they had a 40% off clearance sale. So I ordered a couple of things out of the clearance that I wanted that I didn't already have, which fortunately was at least four, because you needed at least four to get the 40% off. That'll probably be coming next week. Hopefully, that's it. Like, I think I own, at this point, I have to own everything from the clearance section that I want until they add more stuff to clearance. I spend way too much money at Killstar, but I'll only buy stuff from the clearance section with an additional percent off. So I like to get as much as I can for my money, even if I'm still spending way more than I should. This is Goth on a Budget. Nothing here was more than $25. So I guess we'll just open this up and I'll show you what I got this time around. Now, I did have to use a code for this because I did the early access, which was a code. If I'd waited, like, I don't know, 24 hours, I could have gotten, like, the regular sale, and then I wouldn't have needed the code, and then I could have put another code on top of that. But unfortunately, I didn't plan that far ahead, and I was just like, ooh, code for 30% off, and went for it and didn't get an additional. But on the my final, the clearance, 40% off clearance, I was able to use a code on that. I was able to cash in some points for $10 off, which just happened to equal the exact same as shipping because I didn't go over $100 on that order. So at least I got free shipping through the code by cashing in some of my points. But that's not this order. Why am I talking about that when that's not this order? Here are our presses. And I got 8 items. And my total with tax was $109. I'd say that's pretty good for 8 items. First up, more stuff from their leopard print collection, which you guys know I've developed this new love for their leopard print. This is a more form-fitted mini skirt. I have the skater skirt version as well, but this one is a little more form-fitting. And it has like the little zippers on the waist, a little D-ring here in the back, super cute, zips all the way down the front, and there's a strap, or a couple of straps that go on it, I believe, from the front to the back on both sides. And of course, we are going to do try-ons after I show you everything. I do believe I bought everything in an extra large, kinda. I bought most things in an extra large. I'll tell you what's not when I get there. But that was an extra large. My measurements for reference are 40, 33, 43. And I'm normally a extra large US size 12. Okay, so this is one of the things I did not get in an extra large. I actually got this in the 3 extra large. And the reason for that is I already have this. I have this in the extra large. And it's just more form-fitting than I wanted it to be. I wanted it to be like a really loose, comfy tunic top. So I was like, well, if I get the extra large, maybe that'll give me all the extra room that I wanted. But it's just it's the Stormfront tunic, high in the front, has a little opening in the back, and there are thumb holes. But hopefully that'll give me the more loose, comfortable fit that I really wanted from that top, because I bought it as a lounge top, and I'm just not comfortable lounging in figure-hugging things. And of course, it wouldn't be a Killstar order from me if there wasn't at least one velvet dress, right? I feel like I'm always getting at least one velvet dress. I did get this in just the regular extra large. It is sad, though, because a couple of these things, like, if I got it at the 30% off, I could have gotten 40% off, because I still have a couple of the things left in my size. But that's always the risk you run, too. If you don't buy it at the one sale in your size, by the time the new sale comes along, it may not be available in your size. So it's sort of, you gotta play that balance game. But this, I could have gotten an extra 10% off on this. But this is a really pretty velvet dress. I love this burnout pattern with the scrolls and the skulls in it. It's got a square neckline with a heavy velvet collar, and it's long sleeve, and it is lined, unlike the one I'm currently wearing. This is probably more of a like fall winter dress, But it was on clearance, so that would make sense. So this item, I actually went sized down to just a regular large because I bought the extra large and they're just a touch too big on me. I thought I would give the large a try. There was another pair that I also bought in the extra large, but they no longer had that left in a large, so I just got this one. And let's see here. The sale price on these before the 30% off, because I used a code, they're not giving me the extended price. They're just, you know, there's just a discount at the very end. But these were $7 before the 30% off, and then I got 30% off of that. And I'll tell you the prices of all that other stuff as I try it on, but I'm not trying these on for you. Sorry about that. If you were looking forward to that, it's not happening. Okay, now this is... I'm not sure why I do these things. I bought this in a XXL, so I guess a 2 extra large, just because it was so cheap. And they didn't have an extra large or even a large left. But it was $27 before the extra 30% off, so it was only like $20. I don't know if it's gonna fit me. It's always better to have something a little bit too big because you can always alter it, hopefully. Ah, so much. But it's this stretchy dress. It's like this thick, stretchy material, long sleeve, cold shoulder with a keyhole neckline. I just thought it was super cute. And like I said, the price was really good. And you know what? It might even fit me. I might luck out. This might have been one of the items that was cut a little small and will fit me great. But we'll find out here in a minute. Sometimes I just can't resist a deal. Even when I should resist the deal, I just can't. And then next, more of the leopard print stuff. This is a cute little shirt to match that mini skirt. So it's got like one strap on it and tissue protecting the hardware. But yeah, just buttoned down with the one strap that hooks on the back there. And super cute little skulls on the buttons. And then the final thing in this particular Killstar sale order, I got a pair of their knee-high socks in plum. They're like the ripped looking socks. I have no idea if these are going to fit me. I have pretty thick calves and I have problems with a lot of knee-high socks not going up over my calves, and I've heard that Killstar makes a lot of their, you know, socks tiny. I do have two pair of knee-high Killstar socks and they both fit me fine. So hopeful, but at the same time on the incredibly tiny model, and they are one size, they kind of looked like they were squeezing her. So I don't know. We'll find out, hopefully. So yeah, that is everything that I got from the additional 30% off sale. We're gonna go try this on. I'll see you in a second. Starting with this leopard two-piece, and both of these pieces are in an extra large, and both of them fit me really well. They are stretchy, but I don't think I couldn't be too much bigger and still fit into the skirt because the waistband only has like maybe another inch left in it. And let's see, one more time, I'm a 40, 33, 44. Well, I say 43, but the last time I measured, I was actually 44 in the hips. But I still always say 43, I guess just because it rolls easier, because it's like 40, 33, 43. The shirt pulls just a little bit through the bust. I am a 36D. I am surprised, because a lot of times I can get away with size larges, so it always surprises me when an extra large is just a little bit too snug. The other things in this line, in the extra large, have been a perfect fit. But I think it still fits well. It's like, I don't think the pulling is too bad. It could be a lot worse. I could always even unbutton that one if I wanted. The one thing about their like button-up shirts, I don't know what's different about this versus like a normal button-up shirt, but they don't make them in a way that works well if you want to leave like it unbuttoned. It just doesn't lay right. You kind of have to keep their shirts buttoned up. Like, I mean, there is fine, but it just stays over, so it's like you might as well just button it all the way up. That's kind of a weird thing about their shirts. So if you're someone who likes to wear a shirt like this, you know, unbuttoned, which I would like to, you know, it's not necessarily going to work, but it's still really cute. I think it's really cute buttoned all the way up, although I probably wouldn't just because of comfort. I'd probably still leave it buttoned like that, even though it's kind of pointless. But yeah, no, the shirt's super cute. I love it. The skirt is super cute as well. Has the little straps on it. It came with these, which I guess are strap extenders. Like, they've got a little snap, so you fold them over on the ring and snap them like that. So I guess you would, there's two of them, so I'm guessing they're meant for the front ones. So you could, if for some reason you wanted the straps to go longer, you could just snap these on and then put your straps on down here. So that's an option. Or you can just go, let me get back so you can see. So you can keep it at that length, or you can add the extender and take it down even further. But yeah, no, I think it's super cute. If I'm really daring, I might even try wearing this form-fitted skirt with the crop top from this line that I have that has like the strappies. I tend to prefer skater skirts because I kind of like the camouflaging of the hips, but I think I'm getting a little more comfortable with form-fitted stuff these days. So I think that would still be cute with that little crop top. But let me know what you think of these two pieces down in the comments below, and we will move on. The Cat's Meow cap sleeve shirt before the extra 30% off was $28.99 or 98 cents. And this mini skirt I'm still wearing with this top was $23.97. And both of those prices again are before the additional 30% off. So I got like an additional however much money that is, like $6-$7 off. And then the shirt I just put on, this is the Storm long sleeve tunic in plus size. This is the 3XL. And you can see it's still a little bit, not super clingy, but still a little bit form-fitting, even in the 3XL. So you can imagine how form-fitting the extra large was. But I absolutely love the length of this. I could probably get away with this one as a dress, where I think the other one, the extra large, was a little bit too short. But this is about as long as that mini skirt. So I could totally get away with this as a dress if I wanted to. If I just wanted something cozy and casual to throw on, I could add a belt if I wanted more waist definition, or just go loose and comfy if I wanted. So yeah, I'm really happy with the 3XL. I'm still undecided what I'm going to do with the extra large. I might keep it just because it is a totally different look, so it's kind of a totally different mood. I guess not totally, but you know what I mean. It's just like being more, for when I want something more clingy and, you know, just form-fitting, I can wear that one. When I want to be loose and cozy, I can wear this one. So I think I'm plenty happy with that. This was only $20 plus an extra 30% off of that. And I feel like I got the other one for like only $10 or $15 as well. But let's move on to one of the dresses. We just have two dresses and socks left. So here is that burnout velvet dress. And I absolutely love this. I love all little like fit and flare velvet dresses. This is an extra large. I probably could have sized down to a large in this. It's very roomy. Very comfortable and very warm, believe it or not, because it's lined all the way through from the top all the way down to the bottom of the skirt. Like the other little Killstar burnout velvet dress I was just wearing is not lined at all. It's kind of sheer, but this one is definitely lined. This was definitely from probably one of their fall or winter lines. I don't actually remember it. I very seldom look at their full price stuff, so I don't really notice stuff until it hits clearance most of the time, just to not tempt myself too much. Although that Wicked Garden drop they just did, that's been hard to avoid because everyone's in love with it and it is gorgeous, but I'm still not paying that type of prices. If any of it ever makes it to clearance, I'll be on that, but otherwise, I'm not bothering. Even though it is gorgeous. It is absolutely gorgeous. Oh yeah, and the socks actually do fit me. If my legs were thinner, they would actually come way up. So would probably also, because they're supposed to be knee socks, and they will come all the way up my thigh if I want them to. So they would definitely work for someone taller as knee socks. And they are rolling down a little bit, but that's I mean, they're actually made from like a thicker, tight material. So it makes sense that they're rolling down because, you know, tights, the waistband on tights always rolls down. And that's basically what the top of this is, like the waistband of tights. But they're really cute. And I do like them. I think they were only... Prices. Let's see here. They're called the Wretched Soul Distress Socks. And they were $10 before the extra 30% off. And they had them in a bunch of colors. I, of course, went for the purple. But they did have a bunch of other colors. And then this dress is the Angelique Collar Dress in an extra large. And this was $30 before the extra 30% off. But then I would have gotten, what, $6 off, so that would have made it $24, so still under $25. Still got on a budget. But yeah, no, I really like this dress. And then we just have that one final dress left that's in a 2XL, and we'll see if I can make that work. And here we have that final stretchy shirt dress. This is the Chaotica shirt dress in black, and it's the This is the 2XL. It was $27 before the extra 30% off. And then, of course, I got that extra 30% off. And even though it is, you know, it's obviously loose, it's obviously would fit someone a little bit larger than me, I still think it looks fine. I still think that it's, you know, hugs the curves just enough. And if I did want to, I would just have to take the waist in just a little bit, maybe. But... Or I could put a belt on with it. That's always like my go-to. I was able to tighten the straps by one hole, although I don't know if that really made much of a difference. Also, I probably would not wear a strappy bra under this. I would wear more of a push-up bra just to really, you know, give me something to look at in the window. But, oh, I still think it's really cute. I definitely think it was worth the price because I guess it was around after the 30% off, but maybe $20 or so. But yeah, no, I'm plenty happy with it. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. And if you've made it this far, I'm going to do an impromptu giveaway. Because after thinking about it, I'm like, I don't really need two of these Storm long sleeve shirts. And I prefer the way the 3X fits me because, like I said, I just wanted something loose and comfortable. So I'm going to give away the extra large. Now, I did take the tag off, but I did not wear it. I tried it on. But I have not actually worn it yet. It does have cat hair on it, which I'll do my best to clean as much of the cat hair off as I can, but I'm just warning you ahead of time, you might have to do some cat or de-cat hairing to it. Anything in my house for more than 5 minutes gets covered in cat hair. As you guys know, I have 3 of them, and there's no escaping the cat hair. But anyway, this is one of my impromptu giveaways, so I'm really sorry this will be United States only. I just can't afford international shipping on these little impromptu giveaways, so it will be United States only. This is in that size extra large. You saw how the 3XL fits me. So the extra large was very clingy on my measurements of 43, but very stretchy, so it could have even gone larger. It could have fit someone larger than me. It's just if you wanted something form-fitting or not, if that makes sense, because this is a very stretchy fabric. But it is very comfortable and cute and has those thumb holes. Everything's better with thumb holes. Let's see here. My usual impromptu giveaway rules. Have to have an address in the United States I can ship to. Must be 18 years old or older. What are the other rules? I never remember these things. But they'll all be down in the description box below. So to enter, go to the description box below. Read all the rules. To make sure you follow them, you need to, of course, like the video, comment on the video, comment anything you want, but then you'll go to, like I said, the description box, you'll find the Google form. There's going to be a Google form, and then the Google form is just going to ask for your YouTube username, which is just the name that shows up whenever you leave a comment on a YouTube video, so your YouTube username and your email address. So you don't have to have a YouTube channel of your own or anything. The YouTube username, like I said, is just that name that shows up when you comment on a video. So those are the rules. Like the video, comment on the video, go to the Google form, give me the pieces of information the Google form asks, have an address within the United States that I can ship to, 18 years old or older. You guys know the drill. You guys are always so good about these. about these giveaways. So, but that's what we're doing. Go check out the description box to enter to win the extra large Storm t-shirt from Killstar. Like, I thought about it. I really don't need to. I'm getting... Goblin brain wants to hoard everything. It's like, oh, but you might want this look and you might want that look. I don't need both looks. And I wanted the more comfy version. I've got the more comfy version. I'm going to stick with the more comfy version. But let me know what you thought about all of this down in the comment section below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy my video, give it a thumbs up. I will be putting somewhere on the screen when I'm taking entries too. It'll only be... So as usual for my impromptu giveaways, it'll only be a few days out, like maybe four days out or so. Just because I like to churn through these. But I don't know when this video is going up, so that's why I can't tell you what date right now. But I'll put it up on the screen somewhere, and it'll also be down in the description box below. Okay, let me try signing off again. Sorry, I'm so terrible at being, you know, keeping things in a straight line. I'm all over the place. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't enjoy the video, of course you can give me a thumbs down, and please tell me all about it in the comments below. And please subscribe to the channel. And I hope everyone is just staying happy, healthy, and safe in this incredibly crazy world we're living in. And I will talk to you all soon. Bye-bye.